Today, we're going to take a step back from all the business of doing a Minecraft Let's Play series and take a look at how far we've come and why we started this journey. Now that it's complete, I thought it'd be fun to take a look back at phase one of our cinematic Let's Play series, taking some time to discuss topics such as the creative spark for the series, where the inspiration for the video style came from, why I picked to do this series in phases, and what's next for the series. This will be a bit of a meta, talking, update style video, and I'll be talking through all the stuff while showing you some footage of my creative planning for the next phase. I hope you find the topics and format interesting and inspiring. So let's start by talking about the initial idea I had for this series. It all started back in the first half of 2022. I started playing for the first time on some SMPs. I was playing on the Northern Lights SMP and then followed on to the Crossroads SMP. Now, SMP content is great and I really enjoyed playing on these servers and have met some great friends along the way. But I started to get an itch for some single player content that I could take at my own pace and create long-term worlds with. So I started to plan out options for a new series, and I noticed something was a bit off. I was not excited by it, it just all felt meh. It was then that I realized I was getting a bit burned out with the pace and chase of the YouTube meta. All I wanted to do was grow like others had been, and doing a comparison with others' performances, which is really not that healthy. Fast forward a bit to the summer of 2022, and as a family, we were finally able to go back and visit friends and family in Scotland. This is the first trip since the pandemic had started, and it was an incredible time to slow down and relax. I started to get some creative ideas back. Seeing all the different architecture styles around Scotland got me thinking about a new series. So once again, I started to plan out this new series, and I decided that my building theme would be inspired by Scottish architecture. But I knew that I didn't want to rush into this series, and still wanted to do some content on my channel. So I shelved the Scotland idea for the time being, and decided to play some Skyblock for some fun and to give myself a bit more of a reset. Eventually, my creativity came back, and I felt like picking up the Scottish idea again. And it was at this point that I decided that I wanted to do something different from a standard video I'd been doing before. Around this time, two things happened. Firstly, I got myself an Epidemic Sound subscription and spent ages listening to all the music they had to offer. The classical and solo piano pieces really struck a chord with me, and I knew that I wanted to incorporate them into my videos. Though this isn't the traditional style of music used in a Minecraft YouTube, I really did enjoy it, and I just needed to find a video style that fitted with the music. Secondly, I discovered the content of Lime Cookie, and that got me really excited about a more cinematic style. If you've not heard of them before, I'll link them in the description below. Please do go check them out, I'm sure you'll love their content. Their content got me thinking about how to make a more cinematic style of Let's Play, and I started to dive also into some travel vlogs and other B-roll heavy content for inspiration. And so the idea of a more cinematic style was born, and I find that this fits so well with the musical choices we made. So I had the build ideas, the music, and the video style. I just didn't really know how to go about it. So over the Christmas break from work, I started to play around with the replay mod to see what I could come up with. I had never really enjoyed working with replay mod before, as I saw most people use it just to time-lapse their builds. But I set myself some challenges, including the Jaws short film, and I really started to enjoy it and it started to click. And from that time on, I started to work on the cinematic world. So what does my current production rhythm look like with this series? Firstly, I will start at the beginning of the month, writing out titles for the videos that I would like to make. Then, on Thursday and Friday, the week before a video release, I will work on turning that title into a script. My scripts will be split into an intro, an outro, plus normally about 3 sections per video. It will also include ideas for shots that I'll be looking for, as well as my musical choice for that video. Then on the Saturday, a full week before the video's release, I'll work on the intro and ideally 1 to 2 sections. To help me out, as my videos are done completely in replay mod, I try to keep each replay file a maximum of 3 minutes. Sometimes these files will be as low as 30 seconds long, as I'm just looking for one thing for that one perfect shot. When rendering out these shots, I'll go for about 45 for my field of view, recording my voice over the sections I'm working on and putting them all together in DaVinci Resolve. Then on Sunday, it's rinse and repeat of the Saturday for the sections I've not yet done. Then the week before, I'll work on my thumbnail, title, and description, as well as starting to think and plan for the next week. As mentioned before, we are done with phase one in the series, and when planning out the series, I specifically chunked it into phases. One thing I really struggled with in the past with my content was the pacing. I wanted to make weekly videos, but also wanted to do it in a manageable pace. I only have so much time in the week with a full-time job and family to work around, so I decided that if I split the series into phases based around times in history, then that would help me pace myself, as well as helping me keep my build size manageable, at least in the early phase. The phases gave me a soft limitation on builds and resources, which has helped me enjoy playing without the pressure of crazy builds every video. Also, limiting the style, which has helped me focus down on one thing and not get too distracted. Now, these were all my thoughts before the videos started being released, but we are 8 episodes in, so how do I feel now? Well, firstly, I've loved seeing how well these videos have come across. The support on the series has been incredible. My views and watch times have jumped from about 800 views and about 65 hours of watch time in November 2022 to over 2,000 views and 115 hours of watch time in February 2023. This has blown me away how much everyone seems to enjoy this series and the video style. I love reading all the comments as they come in, and I do my best to reply to as many of them as possible. It warms my heart to see all the Bob Ross references or people saying they've been searching for more chill Minecraft content style. It's so lovely to hear from you all. So the final topic of this chatty video is, what's next? Well, for phase two, my plan is to build up a small port town, taking inspiration from places like Tobermory and Anstruther, and many, many more places dotted around the coast of Scotland. The timing will be about the Industrial Revolution, which will mean we can move into some level of automation. I also would love to populate this area with some shops run by villagers, and so we can start with some villager trading. There are currently 2 open questions in my mind for this phase, and I'd love your feedback in the comments. First of all, should I change up the music as we change building locations? Maybe switching it up to some acoustic guitar, or possibly some super chill lo-fi vibes. Secondly, I've toyed with the possibility of moving away from weekly videos and maybe taking 1 week off a month from content. This should help me refresh and also means I can give my family a bit more of my weekend time. Let me know what you think to these options. I hope you've enjoyed this behind the scenes look and listen, and thank you all for amazing support, and I look forward to seeing what comes next in this series. Of course, any ideas and suggestions are more than welcome, so please do leave me a comment on this video. Until next time, bye-bye.